Greetings. Just kidding. We're back with another episode of Dashboard for you. Last week, we dove into tiny tech, handset release news, and some casual quantum computing. Lots has happened since then, so catch up with this link here. We're going to go the opposite direction today and talk big news, makeups and breakups in the corporate world, and of course, keep you updated with what releases are on our radar. So let's fire up the dashboard. AMD has dropped some pretty big news. 6 years ago, this company reemerged into the PC market swinging with goals to be undisputed, and since then, their constant stream of optimizations have kept them ferocious and on track. With the 7nm Ryzen 5000 processors based on Zen 3 microarchitecture, AMD claims that they've achieved their goals.
Yeah, Lisa, you did it!
The Ryzen 5000 CPUs are set to beat Intel in its last specialized area, 1080p gaming, without compromising their existing lead in literally every other metric. There are four new Ryzen 5000 models starting at $299, with the Ryzen 5 5600X all the way up to $799 for the Ryzen 5950X, which will be available for purchase November 5th. What really makes the series so special? The company says that their market-leading single-threaded performance paired with a 19% increase to IPC is a combination that is making a massive difference. This pairing with the optimized 7nm process brings out a 4.9 GHz boost from the Ryzen 5000 Vermeer chips. If these benchmarks hold in further testing, this series may be the new king of the CPU castle. The redesign of the Zen microarchitecture was fundamental to deliver IPC gains, especially when combined with higher peak clock speeds. AMD is clearly proud of this new series and are boldly stating that the Ryzen 5000 chips are faster than Intel in gaming, single, and multi-threaded performance. This includes performance per dollar metrics at almost 3 times better power efficiency in comparison to Comet Lake. Oh, and the chips are also backwards compatible with the existing 500 and 400 series chipsets, so if there's anyone who wants to drop everything and upgrade, this is a fairly affordable option. AMD isn't just sitting pretty at the top of many review lists. They're clearly committed to being the best forever and ever. The Radeon RX 6000 GPUs will support the new AV1 codec designed by AOM, or Alliance for Open Media. NVIDIA and Intel already support this encoder, so it clearly is going to do something right to your setups. AV1 cuts video sizes without cutting into quality, meaning more users can shift away from 1080p and into 4K and even 4K 60fps, which is generally expensive to store and you have to sacrifice your internet speed. It just seems like AMD is doing a lot of good lately, am I right?
You're right.
But Intel has a few other tricks up its sleeve and isn't afraid to use them. Just one day, yes, 24 hours before AMD made its announcement, John Mannini, none other than the VP GM of Intel's desktop workstation and gaming division, confirmed its next-gen desktop platform, Rocket Lake, for Q1 of 2021. Until we know more, we're putting it under their 11th Gen Core branding, which features PCIe 4.0 support, and we're assuming it's based on 14nm process. Whether it was built upon a Skylake architecture like the last 5 gens of NM, or if it's a backport of Intel's latest Cove microarchitecture, we're not sure yet.
Coves, rockets, and lakes.
What was specified in this media release was the emphasis on high processor frequencies as a key performance metric in popular applications and gaming, casually name-dropping Intel's various Turbo Boost technologies. They then cited Intel's ability to overclock processors to 7 GHz, which isn't done on purpose for the sake of gaming and workflow, so yeah. Honestly, it was a bit hard to keep up with all of it. It was posted on the website Medium instead of Intel's page and had some rookie formatting issues, so not quite sure what Mr. Benigni was up to. Actually, I'm exactly sure what he was up to. He was trying to get the jump on AMD's announcement. So are you guys going to hold out for Intel's new chips, or are you scooping up AMD's Ryzen 5000 series? Let me know in the comments below. WD jumped on the announcement bandwagon with its Black SN850 SSD, which apparently is going to give Samsung's 980 Pro a run for its money. This new PCIe 4.0 NVMe SSD, which is the successor to the SN750 in the Black series, will offer some pretty speedy performance for gamers. This unit provides brand spanking new cache tech, reads up to 7,000 megs and writes up to 5,300 megs. It also offers an SSD add-in card and a game dock for extra performance customization. These are the specs they're claiming for the 1TB model, but hold on, there's also a 2TB SSD and a 500GB drive. According to WD, the SN850 NVMe SSD should also deliver an improved low-Q depth performance over its predecessor, which will allow for smoother loading of applications for all users. The SN850 is following similar competitive pricing as the SN750, with an entry-level 500GB version starting at $130. Theoretically, WD's new SSD will offer slightly better performance than Samsung's 980 Pro, which already provides excellent value with just a slightly higher price point. Regardless, WD's performance promises and a lower price tag may tip the scales in their favor. Well, I know how much I like a little bit of drama, but sometimes enough is enough, you know? Apparently, Facebook has hit its limit.
Really?
Kinda. Sorta. Not at all. Sources at Facebook claim that they will pause all political advertising after the US election. Facebook in North America has the longest reaching arm, accessing the majority of citizens through its collection of apps. This makes it one of the best places to launch ad campaigns in general, and politics are obviously no exception. Facebook got some serious backlash from its hands-off approach during the last election, where smear campaigns ran rampant. This time they're making changes.
Are they though?
No. Facebook has launched a string of initiatives to mitigate the harm of misinformation using real-time fact-checking.
Fake news.
But honestly, this is the most too little too late they could possibly get. Essentially, the damage will be done and the profits will be made by the time these initiatives kick into gear. They will place a temporary moratorium on all social issues, electoral, or political ads in the US to avoid voter intimidation and fraud, but only after the polls are closed. You know that person that comes over for dinner, then offers to do the dishes at the very end of the night, but you're already done? Like, Facebook is that person. IBM announced that it would be following in HP's footsteps and shedding some of its lower margin lines of business to a new company, literally called New Company.
Genius.
This strategic divestment means IBM will focus on higher margin cloud services to avoid company sprawl and cannibalizing their own business. Under this new plan, IBM keeps focus on its open hybrid cloud platform, which retains a $1 trillion market opportunity. NewCo will pivot into a leading managed infrastructure service provider since it's life-owning the entirety of IBM's global technology services. They will inherit 4,600 accounts, many of which represent 75% of the Fortune 100. Considering IBM has over 100 years of experience, we like to think that this strategic shift is well thought out. And there's confidence in the market, as stock went up approximately 7% in the days following the press release. I think they should just stick with NewCo. It's easy, it makes sense, it's easy to pronounce, and weird names work too. Just ask Elon. Other ideas are Baby BM or, I don't know, you guys tell me. What should IBM name its new company? Let me know in the comments below. In the actual world of wearables, Canon has announced the M-Real S1, a portable enterprise AR headset for mobile workstations. It provides pass-through AR for head mounts and hands-free viewing or a housing meant for handheld interactions. Earlier this year, Canon unveiled the M-Real Display MD20, a VR headset with pass-through AR using stereoscopic sensors on the front, optical sensors for positional tracking, and VR displays for a mixed reality user experience. The Canon Japan website hasn't released timing or pricing, but they're calling this unit the smallest and lightest video see-through MR device in the history of M-Real. These headsets require PC tether and have been created to work with mobile workstations. It's cheaper and more portable than its predecessors at about the size of a smartphone. The enterprise-focused AR headset is designed for hands-on industrial applications like CAD software, and the handheld was created for easier use at exhibitions. At this point, the M-Real S1 is likely to be a Japan-only device, but we can bet on some future developments from Canon in the years to come.
Wait, what is M-Real?
Thanks to all of you for tuning into this episode as well as the others. Hit that like button and subscribe to our channel. We have the code red of all code reds to announce. Ready? Okay, well here it is. We're giving away one AMD Ryzen 5000 custom workstation to one lucky fan. More details will come and I can't wait to share them with you guys. We've got lots of content coming your way with our monovlogs and of course dashboard. Find us on social media and check out our product lineup at monolithgroup.ca. I'm Jana, this is Dashboard, and I'll see you next week.